Well, this morning, he was considered a shoo-in for mayor of New Orleans, and a life-changing decision not only dashed that hope, but it also sent him to prison. We're talking about Oliver Thomas, and he is talking about his experience in the new play, Reflections 2. Joining us live this morning in our studio to tell us more, we have Mr. Oliver Thomas here, and we also have a cast member, Ms. Gwendolyn Foxworth, to tell us about this venture. First of all, thank you both for being a part of our program. It's a pleasure to have you here, both of you.
Thank you.
Thank you, absolutely.
First of all, let's talk about Reflections 2. First of all, we have to talk about the first Reflections, okay?
Huge success, 13 sellouts.
Yes, you know. I was there. I saw it, and this was supposed to be a play that only should run maybe a few weeks. Right. It kept being extended.
13 straight sellouts. Yeah. We got New York Times, LA Times covered, CNN. But I work with a great cast.
People like Gwen, she is wonderful.
Al Aubrey, Harold X. Evans. So it was a great production. Anthony put on a great production.
Why do you think it was so popular? Well, I know the answer, but why do you think it was so popular?
I mean, first of all, you had to have a good story and good acting, and you had to be able to keep people's attention over the course of 13 straight nights, you know. Mm-hmm. So it was just, the actors did a great job on my story, and I think it was also good writing by Anthony.
What was it like for you to tell your story on that stage?
Well, it was acting. That time it was a little more difficult. You know, but people always ask me, Latanya, they say, well, you know, politics, acting, and I say exactly politics and acting. It's not that big a stretch. Is that just that I think I'm a much better actor now.
Yeah. Well, you know, we all know New Orleans City Councilman. Mm-hmm. You were a shoe-in for mayor, as I mentioned.
No such thing as a shoe-in.
Well, a lot of people would argue with that.
I did pretty good in my last three elections. Were 90, 88, and 87%. So that's not bad.
Yeah, and you pled guilty.
Yeah.
To bribery.
Well, it's owning up to personal responsibility. Mm-hmm. You know, if you do something, you admit it, and then you move on with your life.
You admitted to violating public trust. Did you ever think of taking perhaps a different, more defiant position? Mm-hmm. Because it's somewhat rare for a public official to make such a quick admission as you did.
I wasn't raised like that. I was raised that you accept personal responsibility for your actions, and there's a cause and effect, and there are consequences for your actions. Mm-hmm. It's not about anybody else. It's about you. And moving on with your life, and that's what I did. That's the way my mother and father raised me.
And we have followed you throughout this whole journey.
And it's been a great life, man. You know, I host one of the top morning shows in the city.
Yes.
I've done movies and plays and HBO specials and series, and it's been really, I really love the public. I love the people in the city.
You played a councilman on the HBO series Treme.
Yeah.
What are the chances of you returning to public office? I know you can hear that a lot.
It's not something that I think about. I understand now that my poll numbers are pretty good, but mm-hmm. but for me, I want to see good young men and women offer themselves for service. If I can do anything to help them, but if I can use my life as an example of what not to do, I don't mind. I'm not afraid to do that. Anthony challenged me early on. He said, "Look, can you only lead when things are going well?" Mm-hmm. You know, because initially I didn't want to do the first Reflections. I kind of want to kind of go away. And he said, "Hey, look, what about being a leader when you're up and when you're down?" And I accepted that. He said, "Let's use your story to show others about the trappings of power, about how the intersection between public service and you know, and how good people get caught up and how families get affected." And I agreed to do that, and we put on a good show.
That's
put on a good show
again.
Absolutely.
Reflections too. Gwendolyn, jump in here. You play the wife.
Yes.
Of Mr. Oliver Thomas in this play. Tell me how your role changes from the first Reflections to Reflections 2, and what happens in the marriage.
Well, really, the role is a progression from the first production, and we begin to see more of the dynamics of the stress of public life on a marriage, mm-hmm. And ultimately how it can destroy a marriage. Mm-hmm. So all of the details now are provided. Questions that you may have had in your mind from the last play, you know, well, I wonder what happens, you know, when between them when this went on, mm-hmm. you know, I wonder. So all of these questions now are answered and revealed, and it's amazing. amazing to me that these two individuals, Oliver and his ex-wife, Angel, are willing to share this, because I think that people will be able to watch it and they are going to be moved and they're going to be touched, because all of us in our personal lives as adults have experienced the ups and downs of a relationship.
So too often celebrities forget about the people who help catapult them there. Whether it's public officials, whether it's television personalities, or sports figures. You know, your family was good enough when you were making that struggle, and once you become famous, you know, it has an effect on on the family, and I was definitely a victim of that. And I think hopefully we can use life to show people, hey, look, the most important thing, it's not a choice between public service and family. It should never be a choice. Family should always be first.
Speaking of public service, people say you had your choice and you blew it. You say what?
Well, it's not really about me, and you never blow it. As long as you, I always tell people, make today the best day you ever had until tomorrow. You know, every day you get up, you have a chance to make a difference. And Reflections 2 and Reflections 1 really was not as much about Oliver Thomas as people who go through the same thing. Mm-hmm. And when I tell folk, my life is pretty good. But there are other men and women who've had felony convictions, who don't have my notoriety, a celebrity, who don't have my education or relationships. They should be given opportunities too. They've done their time, they've paid their debt to society, and it's time for people to move on. And all of these people who shine their halos, I'm kind of scared of them. You know, I like to line up with people who've been down and got back up. Those are the best people in the world.
Speaking of people who made the choice, you know, served their time and paid their debt to society, before we go, your comments on former Louisiana Governor Edwin Edwards running for Congress.
One of the great political minds and personalities in the country. He was on my show. He answered every question about national politics and interests better than anybody I've talked to in the last couple of years. So, you know, whether people are going to vote for him or not, that'll happen when the election comes up. But he's a brilliant politician.
All right, thank you so much. We got to leave it there. Once again, it is Reflections 2. You can catch it at the Anthony Bean Theater. It starts April 11th. For more information on when you can catch it, the times, and all of that, just log on to the website, anthonybeantheater.com. Thank you.